Victims of the Angora fire are trying to rebuild their homes and their lives after one of the largest disasters ever in El Dorado County. The financial toll is adding up in ways most of us could never imagine.
Now that the ash is settled, it's time to clean up and clear out. But that is a monumental task, considering the hazardous debris and hundreds of dead and dying trees that must be removed.
As Call 3's Lindsay Paolo explains, some of that rests on the already burdened shoulders of the victims.
Oyarz Mazulis is one of the unlucky ones. His family lost their vacation home. Their only solace, they're not homeless.
It's no fun, but at least we're not primary residents here. You know, it's a second home, so we didn't lose anything but stuff.
But the burden of being a victim is sinking in. Before they can rebuild, homeowners have to remove debris and trees from their property. Mazulis has about 40 trees.
I have to pay to have them removed. There is no government agency as of this time that has come forward.
That can cost thousands of dollars. If homeowners sell the timber, they get a wood credit. But licensed timber operators say it's not enough to cover removing the trees. Structural debris, that's the houses, is a different story.
Under the county state plan, homeowners can agree to let state-managed contractors actually handle their household debris removal. Then any of their insurance money that's designated for that purpose will come back to the county and then be reimbursed to the state.
Homeowners aren't liable for any cost. What insurance doesn't cover, the state picks up. So far, 189 home sites have registered for the program. Crews have cleared 5 properties and are working on 8 more right now. And Call 3 has learned the county and state met today to work toward a similar plan to help with tree removal.
We recognize that trees are also a huge obstacle to getting people moved in and made whole again. So we're working on ideas to try to provide some assistance with trees.
I'd like for there to be an easier system to do it, but if there isn't, then I have to deal with it.
In El Dorado County, Lindsay Paolo, KCRA 3 reports.
Now, officials did not test the debris, but they say it is probably hazardous because of what they found during the Oakland Hills and San Diego fires. So they're taking precautions, including air monitoring in that area to protect the workers and the neighbors.